shit's like 6 minutes long. You can get past that shit.
Somewhere between I want it and I got it. Somewhere between I'm sober and I'm lifted.
It gets better.
Somewhere between a mistress and commitment, but I stay down. Girl, I always stay down.
And you know what? Niggas be dissing this cat.
Everybody on me before I break down. Everyone just wait now. So much on my plate now.
That's the thing. That's what I figured out. Niggas that are like super macho and afraid to be, you know. That's what it seems like to me. I'm hearing a lot of negative shit about Drake. And it's like, you know, he's doing what he does. You know what I'm saying? If you don't like it, turn the shit off. You know what I'm saying? Like, really, I mean. Stay dissing this nigga. I'm like, he's doing what Cash Money put him on to do. What the fuck? What do you expect? Like, what more do you want? This shit isn't, you know, and I heard somebody say some shit like niggas that listen to Drake. What the fuck is that nigga saying? That was some freaking Facebook shit. I forgot. I should have wrote that shit down, man. He was like, saying that only a certain kind of person you listen to. What the fuck are you talking about? Like, come on, it's music, man. It's nothing more than that. Like, it's not that serious. Like, what the fuck? It's, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, he's on some, you know, he's known for some emotional shit. But you listen to the music, you know? I mean, it's kind of basic. It's kind of, but the shit is quality. And I can, you can actually, you know what I'm saying? You can play track after track after track after track. I can't do that with Kendrick Lamar shit, man. His latest shit, Good Kid, Tough City, whatever the hell that shit's called. What the fuck does that even mean? You know what? Like, I can play certain joints, but not one after another. He's got heavy hitters on that album, man. Definitely does. But it's like far and in between. Like, you got like two or three tracks. I can literally listen to the music of Drake shit more. Without wanting to, you know, without needing to, if anything, I rewind the shit to the next shit. Like, this shit he's got on here after all this introduction bullshit.
It's the shit I wanna go out to.
This shit right here, like, how would you only drop one verse on this shit?
It's the shit I wanna go out to.
Rip the shit out of this beat, man. Woo! Come on, man. Listen to that fucking heavy bass, man. This is fucking rugged, man. I feel like looping that shit myself, man. Going out like the niggas that I was just talking about.
I've been on the love. Fuck it.
I love this beat. I love this shit.
Million and some children, that's just how I'm feeling. A nigga filling up arenas, who the fuck will see us? I had to dare Rose and Neo.
And you know, we sound like Jay-Z and shit. I thought it was Jay at first. He's even spitting like him. So I'm like, yo, the nigga, did Jay-Z ghostwrite this shit? I think so. Possibilities are endless, nigga. He spit like Jay. Come on. Jay-Z wrote that shit, man. Jay-Z's not the best lyricist, but you know how he sounds. And I swear that, yo, I had to listen to it like four or five times, you know what I'm saying? Like, tough, like, closely, like. Sounds a little too much like Jay right there, boy. Oh no. That's what niggas is doing too. A lot. His known cats. And that's the thing, man. Like, you know, like, what's his name? Let that out the bag, man. Like, what's his name? Kanye's boy. He was like, yo, I go straight for that nigga. But ain't no secret, nigga. Like, niggas, they been doing that shit. It ain't nothing really wrong. I mean, well, yeah, it is. You know what I'm saying? It is. To be an MC, EMC, you gotta write your own shit. Now, singers, R&B niggas, they don't, all they gotta do is do their thing on the stage. You know what I'm saying? They don't gotta write shit, really. But it's a plus, like, you know what I'm saying, when they produce and write shit, I look for that too. Like, I appreciate niggas that produce and write their own shit, like me. Like, on my singing shit, I wrote a lot of singing shit for Fool. Sometimes I add, you know, I ghostwrite a few lines or whatever for his solo shit. I love to write, man. You know, it's challenging to do R&B. I'm not gonna front on that. You know what I'm saying? Especially, like, I got two tracks right now. I'm struggling with them. I'm hoping Martine can fucking bless me, man, with her kind of sound. Cause it's two R&B. It's like not really R&B tracks, but the hip hop. But it's, they kind of have an R&B feel to them, kind of, sort of. I want, like, some R&B vocals on those shits. So hopefully I'm gonna throw them at Fool and at Paul Martine to see what they can do with it. Paul's not getting back at me, man. All I can say is that I'm, you know, when it comes to the whose album is harder, Jay-Z's album is kind of bullshit to me, man. Like, he's got like maybe four joints on his whole album this year that I can fuck with. That one with his wife is nice, man. He's got like a couple of joints. But that fucking, I forgot the name of that shit. That trap beat, that trap shit, that is promoted pretty hard. I'm not feeling it. And I probably, you know, if I was twisted enough, if I was like, you know, drunk enough, I don't know. I don't think that'll do it. Just certain shit don't really move me, man. You know? And back when they had the commercial for that shit, I was excited. It kind of moved me. And they had the commercial for that shit. Man, that fat nigga in the front was playing, you know, I guess the producer of that beat or whatever. And the engineer or whatever. And you see Jay-Z showing that background and shit in the black and white. I was like, okay, what's this shit gonna be about? When I put his album side by side, Kendrick Lamar's shit and Drake's, this shit is lagging behind, like intensely. Kendrick Lamar, like I said, he got some heavy hitters. He got a flow, especially with that triple time and rhyme shit, that Busta Rhymes shit niggas be doing. Got a flow with Drake, I think. Overall, instrumentally and not so much vocally, but the beat-wise, and somewhat lyrically. Nothing was the same. I give it a 5.5. Beat-wise, I give it a 6.5. Kendrick Lamar's shit, what was this shit called? Good Kid, New City. I give the beats, give you a 4.5. Lyrically, I give you a hard 6, I think. Because you're new, you know what I'm saying? You ain't really Swimming pools is still my shit. And this other shit, hold on.
Yours truly the boy. I just build and build more. Y'all niggas build and destroy. Y'all niggas party too much, man. I just chill and record. No feeling, you feel it now. If you ain't feeling,
oh Lord, oh yes, Lord.
This is shit I wanna go out to.
Shit I wanna go out to, nigga.
Yeah. Yeah.
Drinking, smoking, fucking, plotting, scheming, getting money. Drinking, fucking, smoking, plotting, scheming,
This the life for me. My mama told me this was right for me. I got him worried, like, make sure you save a slice for me. I should have spoon serve you up with a fork and knife for me. Your actions make us doubt you.